Hello guys, so welcome to our Breaking the Brave Frontier, and today I'm going to be doing the newest Arsenal 4 mission, which is... Real Ukraine. It's not that hard, I mean, you can even solo it without getting help from other players. Yeah. So, here's my squad. I'm using the Elmo Raga for Radiant Zero, so I'm going to explain further in this video. The reasons why I chose those units for this RC mission. Alright, so I think everyone's ready, and let's mobilize. So our goal here is to kill really Granny. He's located at the top left corner of the map. Yeah, then he's located yep, on the clock. He's the boss is at the clock tower, so we have to go there. Alright, so we only have three players joining in. In my room, yeah. Alright, first of all, because you need a mitigator. And unit that increase HC drop rate, and also a unit that increase BB gauge, because the boss he can use BB drain one of the units, so that's gonna be troublesome if you don't have any units that boost BB gauge or BB gauge when attacked. But the most recommended here is a unit that boosts BB gauge and boosts attack by 100%, so you can get a high score after beating the boss. Alright, so Elmo is our mitigator. Raga, spark buffer. There are spark buffers for an HC, BC drop rate buffer. Since I'm not using cold for this one. Gura for the BB gauge for right on this SBB, and Yura for the unlimited SPB and DOT debuff, and Quaid for the four elements buff. It basically means you can use all four elements if you have Quaid in squad. Actually, I can use all elements because I have Gradus in squad as well, so. Yeah, so my damage will be doubled because of the fire, earth, thunder, water, light and dark element buff. So let's talk about all the new stuff that's gonna arrive on global soon. First of all, the SBS 7 stars units will get their 7 stars probably at the end of July. Yeah. Well, they announced it pretty early last month, so I'm guessing Ultor and Trident 7 stars will be released first on the 31st of July, if I'm correct, yeah. 31st of July, yeah. So it's good that the SBL teams are getting 7 stars, because their 6 stars are pretty much not that strong anymore because of the new 7 stars. If you're gonna compare Grad to Trident 6 stars, Gra is still superior over each other. Because of his 35% boost to stats, all stats. And, Trident, he's only good because of his Earth Shield and 15% mitigation. He's good if you don't have Gra. 6 star Gra, yeah. But once you evolve Gra to 6 stars, Trident is pretty much useless now. Well, it's still useful in Grand Quests and Trials, but a lot of people have stopped using it for a while. And then, yeah. Alright. Also, Lyra's Grand Gaia Chronicles will be released soon on Bubbles, but didn't expect that to happen, so we have to restart the game. This is why, they need good minutes to fix also Sarah's on Brave Frontier, especially on raid battles. It happens quite often on raids. I'm gonna get those good ass points. Well, it's good that we're getting another GGC dungeon on global. They just recently released Michelle's dungeon, which is the 10-winged tormentor. And I'm not gonna lie, guys, it's one of the hardest GGC dungeons in the game so far. I still can't get through Battle 2. And the outcome of the battle quest, which is Michelle's dungeon level 3. I was so close, but my squad got wiped out after I used Raga's UBB. That's really BS. They should have made Zelban loading that OP, because they can remove all your buffs and leader skill sometimes, so that's pretty annoying. I mean, it's harder than Kikuri and Michelle's, Kikuri and Sefia's GGC. Well, I guess RNG worked for me as well, so that's why I managed to clear Kikuri and Sefia's dungeon. The third one, the Blaze and Blossoms. That one was a little bit difficult if you don't have the right units for it. It's a good thing I have Yura there, because the DOT really helped push the damage on Kikuri and Sefia. And Raga as well for the spark damage. So just finish them off. By spamming SBB and BBs, and when their HP reached at 10%, and I killed them both at the same time, which is the only way to beat that dungeon. You see, I have to kill Kikuri and Sefia at the same time, because if you don't kill Kikuri and Sefia, Kikuri will revive, or Sefia, and it's going to be harder, because they're going to be using the leader skill disabled that ability again, so you don't want that to happen, it's best to kill them as soon as possible. Pretty sure he hasn't killed the boss yet, so we still have a chance here to steal the point. Yeah, let's just skip this battle. Yeah, so that's pretty much it for Kikuri's and Sefia's dungeon, and Michelle's GGC dungeon as well. So let's discuss about Miku's 6-star, which is rumored to be released on global this month. I don't know, I'm seeing a lot of info about Miku's 6-stars floating around in Reddit. Yeah, it's a website where you see all the updates on Brave Frontier Global in Japan. Yeah. So that's actually a good thing, because I haven't... got Miku yet. And I will definitely... capture Miku once the dungeon has been released again. So, yeah. I mean, Miku's the only one who hasn't gotten six stars among the book lords. Yeah. They seriously need to upgrade her, so people will be able to use her again. So as you can see, I'm just auto-battling this post-battle. Yep. Doesn't matter, just keep on spamming SBBs and BBs. And the boss will die in a few minutes. Alright. Yeah. So what do you think Miku's SBB will be like? Is it going to be the same as her 5 stars BB? Which boosts BB gauge greatly, I think? And BCH drop rate as well? Or is it going to be different? Something different. Yeah. Comment down your thoughts in the comment section down below. Alright. Now let's get on to the... Oh, just run away. How could you? Alright, so we're going to have to chase the boss now. So the boss will go to Gentle Riverbank. And if the boss runs away, if the boss escapes again, he's going back to where he first... Where he first appeared, yeah. To the place where he first appeared. Which is that tower over there. Alright, so... What was I gonna say? So, oh yeah, the new stuff in global, I think we're also getting a new, grand quest for this month as well, yeah. Yeah, I think it's they're working on Adea's Grand Quest at the moment, so it'll probably be released a few weeks from now. Yeah, it's probably the best Grand Quests in the game by far. I really want to do Adea's story and the Heroes of Palmina as well. Is there a pretty interesting bunch? Loden, Michelle, SGX, Tiara, they all joined forces together to defeat Melchior. And if you guys cleared the 10 Ming Tormentor Level 3 after battle, you will see that SGX sacrificed his life to protect Michelle. I think, yeah, yes, SGX sacrificed his life to protect Michelle. So he's self-destructed, so that he can protect Michelle. What a sad ending. And the only one left. And the only thing left after he exploded was just a little piece of his metallic body, which is the dual fragment. Yeah, dual fragment. And you get that fragment as a spear. I'm not sure what it does, but it's a pretty good spear too. Yeah. Oh, it's already finished. That was quick. That was really quick, guys. Let's see the score. Picking Ravage 2. My score. Alright, I'm gonna kick this 2 out, and it's we're gonna do a single solo raid mission now. This time on the first boss. Oh, we can do the second one, I reckon. Yep, this is the second one. Yeah, let's do this one. Grandma's probably not. Oh, this is one from Deadlands. Means we can all this. So for this one, we're gonna change our leader to Uro, since the boss can drain your BB gauge. Let's put in Guru at the end. I don't want to use Sedge in front though. She's a pretty good unit as well. Sedging. The unit that you can get from Trial X3. Where's the Guru? Freaking Guru. Where are you? Oh, don't tell me he changes his lead. Oh please, I need your Guru for this one. Oh yeah, oh. Did it change this one? Can't find it. The Guru that has freaking. Oh, there it is, it's real. Mouse jewel and fancy one. Alright. Then we should be good with this setup. I don't know, let's replace Claire with the Colt so we so my units will get crit buff every time they use PB and SPB or SP, yeah. Since I already have Rogue on this one. You don't need to crit spark buffers in this one. You're doing this RC4 mission. Alright, let's mobilize. Let's talk to these guys. Where's that ready icon? Yeah. Let's see if these guys are gonna reply. Ready. Ready. Alright. They're not replying. Let's just mobilize. Alright. We have Fever though. Who's not AFK at the moment. Well, really is AFK at the moment. So that means she won't be able to join in this mission. As I change the settings to. Join mid, not join midway. Alright, so for this RC mission, there's two bosses here, Midzug, and I can't remember the other one, but he's a lightning element boss type unit, yeah. You should be at the boss. At the boss now. We should be at the boss now. Still have a long way to go. I think those are the only new stuff that Globo will release for this month of July. Yeah. Well, I'm hoping they would release the next 7 stars batch quite soon as well. The Reese batch. It's one of my favorite 7 stars batch in the game. And I freaking want to get Totetsu. In that batch, yeah. Totetsu, Nemesis Gear, and Reese, yeah, Reese, Totetsu, Nemesis Gear. Those are the 3 units that I want to get from that batch. So we're gonna talk about the next thing that we're gonna talk about is the new trial, which is trial number 6 versus Aphlodilith. So Aphlodilith is one of the 4 fallen gods, and he has finally gotten his trial on global. So Aphlodilith is one of the easiest bosses in trials so far. I mean, Maxwell is even easier than him. Zabal was a lot harder, though. So the one thing that you have to keep in mind when you're fighting against Aphlodilith is that he can do a massive single target attack at 70%, 90%, 70%, 60%. At 30%. So I'm gonna tell you how to survive those massive single attacks. So the move is called Void Casualty. It's a single massive dark attack on a unit that has the lowest HP, highest attack, lowest defense, highest HP, and unit that has 50% BPH. So in order to survive that move, you just have to guard that unit that has the lowest defense at 90%. Yeah, you have to guard that unit and use Elimos or any mitigators as BB or BB. Alright, so we get out of this now. Yeah. It's the same for the HP marker at 70%, 6%, 30%. You just have to run those units. So once you get past those HP markers, he will summon Zerg at 60%, 70%. So Zerg is a... he's the one that you have to kill first. Before you can start crushing Aphlodilith. One thing you have to know is that if Aphlodilith's HP is at 50% and Zerg is dead, and you accidentally kill Zerg, he will do a massive buff, attack buff, on himself, and he will do a massive AoE attack that can't be guarded or mitigated. So the best way to avoid that is to kill Zerg at 50% HP. When he starts saying some shit, yeah. So there's a time to kill Zerg. Or you can kill Zerg and hopefully bring Alpha's HP down to 50%. So that's what some people did. So once you get past that, Alpha will do a AoE attack that has DOT debuff on it, so your units will be poisoned every turn. So yeah, stop that shit. Both Umbrella are still cursed. So I had to use Aimless Speed the next turn. Yep. So once he does that DOT debuff, make sure to mitigate and heal with Elbow. It's much better if you have Serena, Brielle, or Fiva in this one. Because, it's really hard to beat after the. If you don't have any healers in your squad, you get my minion. Yeah, so that's all you need to counter his DOT debuff. So even if you get poisoned, your units will still automatically heal at the end of your turn. Yep. So once you get past that, Alpha will now do the last two massive single target attacks on units that has the highest HP and 50% BB gauge. So what I did there is I just guarded my highest HP unit and mitigated my whole squad. But I didn't guard the units 50% BB gauge. So he got killed in the process, yeah. That's why you need a couple of reroutes when you're fighting against Alpha Dio. Yeah, so I revived that unit and I was able to survive those massive single target attacks. Now once all should be rested, we can kill this. We can kill here now, but this mess is just. To OP Bombardier. But I'm using Obua here for the extra defense buff. And my Euro still got wrecked. Alright, going back to Apple Dude's try. So once you get past that 30% HP marker, we just have to bring her down to 20%, to 25% now to trigger and his first endless. So the first endless is just a normal dark. It's just a normal massive dark AoE attack. So it's 33 hits. So you get it. And you can survive that by using. Well, she's got away. You can survive that by using Elmo CBB. I mean, SBB. So just mitigate. So where did the boss go now? Forest back. So I did the snowy path. Oh shit. Alright, how many do I have left? Oh, you need some 7. Defeated that boss yet. I'm not sure, but Yeah, so... the trick to surviving his first endless is just mitigating drawing. Yeah. And make sure units have full HP. The second one though is a bit tricky because he uses an extra element on his endless. So there is a huge chance that one of your non-dark units will be wiped out by the seven endless. So the best way to survive that is to guard that unit. If it's Earth, and Aqua's element change to Earth, and he did endless after that turn, after he changed element to Earth, so discard that Earth unit, as simple as that. Once you get past this last endless, which is the second endless, you have pretty much won the trial. Just keep spamming your SBVs and BVs until he reach the 5% HP, and finish him off with the next turn. So yeah, that's how you beat Alpha Dilith. All right. So what else should we talk about? Oh yeah, the new Metal Rush. Yeah, the new Metal Rush mission on Global. Yeah, it was released a few days ago. It was a pretty fun mission. You get tons of medals every time you complete a Metal Rush mission. So the Metal Rush mission ranges from RC1 to RC4. RC1 being the easiest, and RC4 being the hardest. So it's highly recommended for you guys out there to do RC4 Metal Rush, because it gives you more than 30 medals sometimes, yeah. Gives you tons of medals. Right. Also just so hard to kill. We only have 15 minutes left. Don't think we're gonna make it. Let's just do the best that we can. Unfortunately the middle rush has ended, so... but the good thing is I managed to... managed to save up 200 minutes from the middle rush. We'll be using those medals to get crystals, fear frogs, and burst frogs. Hopefully, they will add burst adversary and party soon. And the slot machine, yeah. And the new slot machine in Japan. Looks 10 times. Looks 10 times. Much, 10 times. Yeah, it looks better than the one in the global right now. So yeah, that's just all good. I should have attacked you. I did the best for you. I really hate it when he does a 3D page training attack. Oh no, oh yeah. The freaking fever hammer. Try to kill the boss. Also, there's a new fan contest on Global. It's happening right now. It's a grand. I can't remember what it's called. But it's an event that encourages players to make a YouTube video and upload it on YouTube. And once they get more than 10,000 views, they will receive a certain award from Global. A certain reward from Global, yeah. So yeah, it's a pretty huge event. I mean, I've seen a lot of players post their YouTube I've seen a lot of YouTube players post their Grand Fest gameplay on YouTube. And the reason they probably did that is because they just want Windows Goody goodies from Goody. Yeah. Oh shit. I was supposed to send this video there to remove the curse on the roof. For the boss. It's a pretty long video, guys. Well, I hope the boss has a lot of video after this. We should just waste the time and call this a wrap. I still haven't killed it though. This boss is really tough. We're down to 10 minutes and Mizu is still there, waiting for us to beat him. Beat his ass. Put his ass over. Sorry, Mizu, but I want to. I believe I won't make it in time. I'm abusing over USBB. We should just let Fever kill this Balmeria thing. Only the boss. What? I missed that again. So this is why I don't auto battle sometimes, because sometimes you mess up. And that's why. You lose in the game. You lose the. That's why you. That's why you're losing this resolution. Actually, maybe he's a wrong to be beard fish to kill the boss faster. Yeah, well, no, it's just a wrong to be beard. Are you freaking? Or maybe just reduce Angua's BB gauge to half, almost half, yeah. Someone should kill that freaking Mutsu. No, Raga. Raga almost had it with his HP, so surviving that. Good props to Raga. He's surviving this part here. Ah, shucks. God damn dude. Oh come on, stop cursing me. Just die already, Bama dude. Just wasted another orb. Look at that. Look at that. Even around the city, you can kill this. This freaking monster. It's just too OP. Oh, yes. And also, will you be releasing RC5? In a few weeks as well, so I'm definitely looking forward to that. RC5 is one of the hardest missions in the game so far, and the rewards for RC5 is pretty demanding. Why is it so demanding? Oh yeah, it's because you can get Owen once completed our spell. Owen is a pretty beast, you know. His Gra with a critical damage buff, seriously. Yeah. Can't wait to get Owen. Five minutes. And Mizuga is at that avalanche zone. So we have to go there. It's gonna take me forever before I reach Mitsuk's hideout. Oh, we got 4 minutes left. Let's just waste our time. Thank you. I'm gonna stop this video in 5 minutes. Let's just waste our time here. And the last thing I wanna say is, I'm absolutely hyped for trial number 7. Yeah. Can't wait to fight Ark. It's one of the best side stories we need to the game by far. I hope I can beat him in my first try. Well, we'll see. Ark is a pretty beast unit. I have 25% boost to all stats, plus 75% boost to spot damage, and boost piercing HD drop with your spot. That's so cool. He's like lava, fused with Fever and Gra. Yeah, Rubber, Fever and Gra. And his SPD, he has a pretty good skills. SPD boost, attack for 3 turns, and SPD increases normal hit count. So you don't even need, you don't need to lean in the squad if you have Ark in your squad, yeah. And his UBB boosts spawn damage by 500%, attack by 500%, and casts all elements on your squad. That's the best CB in the game by far. The Ruggle has the best CB, but it was Ark. So yeah, so I say that, guys. Just let's wrap this up, right? Yeah, I will be doing a video on what the time just moved back to 1 minute. That is some BS. Yeah. Yeah. So we failed the quest. And guys, so thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.